Corals are threatened like never before, and coral reefs as ecosystems are perhaps one of the world's most threatened ecosystems from the point of view of climate change. But there are in fact hundreds of millions of people around the world who all depend on coral reefs for their livelihoods. And they're also incredibly valuable in protecting our coastlines.
There's a good scope for a National Academy of Sciences, Engineering and Medicine review to come together and really look at what's the problem, what can we do from the best possible science, because we really need science to be the foundation.
This review of interventions brought together a wide-ranging set of scientists, and we delved into the literature on what people have been talking about for the last couple of years, sometimes for the last couple of decades, about how to increase coral resilience in the face of mostly ocean warming. Our first report contains a list and a deep dive into each of 23 different interventions that people around the world have been thinking about.
We're testing whether corals from the Eastern and Western Caribbean can breed with each other, and then testing whether any of their babies are extra strong, extra fit, extra good at growing fast or reproducing well, or surviving warm temperatures.
The topic and the focus of our second report is to how to take this set of tools and then decide how and when and where to apply them in any particular given circumstance.
The report was originally commissioned by NOAA, and it's very management directed in terms of how do we take the best of modern knowledge and really move from the science to policy realm and also from knowledge to action.
You know, my belief is that we haven't solved it yet because we haven't had a serious crack at solving it. And I'm a firm believer that we can bring some of these ideas to the table and start using them.
This report really is about a bridge to the next century. What will it take to allow coral reefs to survive that period of time and still produce the kinds of services and value to human communities that they do now?